So here I am, day after day, year after year, and way past my expiration date.
Snap out of it!
Oh!
I have been waiting to do this properly for so long.
What do you mean you don't have a thing to wear?
Pinch me.
Ow!
Pay attention to her. Make her feel wanted and important.
People are starting to notice.
You look amazing.
All characters are transformed, or you don't really have a movie. You don't have a story. So some are more subtle, some are less. Sometimes the story is this person refuses to change, and then they do.
I think the whole of costume design is about transformation. I mean, we actually begin with transformation. We're transforming the actor in front of us from who they are into their characters. I think audiences really want to see a transformation. They love to see rags to riches. It's an old story, and it always works. It's always exciting to see.
You see this creature with her curbstone English? Well, sir, in 3 months, I could pass her off as a duchess at an ambassador's reception.
I think costumes are so integral to character transformations on film because clothing is just so inextricably linked to identity. The challenge of capturing both the before and after of a character's transformation lies in finding a single thread of continuity, because the costume designer has to retain the essence of the actor, but also the truth of the character. Because if this transformation is so dramatic, this is, after all, a film, you don't want your audience thinking that this actor is actually playing two different characters. So I think actually finding that connective thread is essential to doing the transformation justice.
In that dress, you're rather like a chameleon.
Likely.
You haven't a very high opinion of yourself, have you?
I tend to go back to the mothership of Warner Brothers films, like now Voyager. It's very unsubtle when Bette Davis goes from a thick-waisted monobrow of woman who is afraid of her own shadow to a very chic woman with many friends that she's made on her ship crossings.
We thought we'd lost you. What a jam.
We're looking everywhere for you. We wanted to say goodbye.
Don't anybody say goodbye. Not anybody. Just au revoir. It is a sad time, isn't it? But I want to tell you one thing. There was no lady on this cruise that was as popular as you were.
Oh, thank you.
That contrast of knowing where she comes from and then the complete 180 reveal into this elegant woman help their character believe what they're going through and what their transformation is.
I love that movie so much, and I love the way that Ori Kelly tells the story from heavy padding to heavy tweeds. And then the reveal, I always love a good reveal, from orthopedic shoe to a shapely ankle.
Those fabulous two-toned spectator pumps that really is the first look that we get of her following her character's transformation into a woman who has more agency than she did before. Shoes help to facilitate transformation in that these characters are then able to walk into these new scenes with newfound confidence or style.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, you look simply gorgeous. I just love your dress.
Thank you, June.
Each character has a dramatic arc, so I would say costume is meant to be woven into the tapestry of the narrative. And if you see the costumes, it's probably because the director has chosen to reveal something about that character at that moment.
What?
Because it is up to the director to either conceal or to reveal personality about those characters.
Great guns, what are you made up for? The seeing eye?
The challenge for a transformative costume is you have somewhere to go from and somewhere to go to. So there's got to be quite an exaggerated jump in a sense. I mean, but then equally, you could have a slow progression. You could actually see somebody's arc and see how they get from A to B. But the most exciting ones are the ones that happen like that, you know, with a fairy godmother usually.
I think the ugly duckling to a swan story we keep coming back to, because that's the fantasy. We all want to be swans at some point. And it's entertainment, but it's also, it's such a soulful thought. And you get to live that experience watching the movie and emotionally feeling it. And even though it wasn't you today, but it was somebody. And I think it's a very hopeful thought.
Who is she? I can't imagine.
If you notice the clothes, maybe that's the moment in which she comes down for the prom, or she comes down for the ball, or your director has taken the time to let the camera linger on her, standing at the top of the stairs. Just think about My Fair Lady. There she is, about to go to the ball, and then walking down the stairs. That's a costume moment, but it's also one of those moments where the music swells and the audience is invited to fall in love with her.
Wow. I think I've just fallen in love with you all over again.
I think clothing can give somebody confidence if it's something that they're not used to wearing before. It's almost a bit like wearing a mask or a veil. It's something that you can hide behind and you can almost pretend that you're somebody else. So that character will have the confidence to appear to be somebody else because they're wearing something that's unfamiliar to them or they're not used to.
Tootsie, take 10.
Han, my name is Dorothy. It's not Tootsie or Toots or Sweetie or Honey or Dow.
Oh, Christ.
No, just Dorothy.
When you're changing gender, as Dustin Hoffman did in Tootsie, he needed that costuming, the hair and the makeup to fully believe that he could be this person. And the longer the ruse continues, it sort of builds his confidence to the point that he really believes in himself. He sees what the power of wearing women's clothing can bring as opposed to what happens in a man's power suit. It's like a whole new view of what power is to him.
Stop thinking of me as a woman and start thinking of me as a person.
When I designed the Joker, Todd Phillips wanted this origin story to be very naturalistic, very much a real person who, through a series of events, turns into something else. The one exciting thing that he does is he works as a clown on the side, but has aspirations of being a stand-up comic. So we see him in his clown outfit, we see him in his suit, and at some point I put the two of them together so that the audience understands where he got his clothes. The waistcoat that he wears as the Joker was the vest that he wears as a clown. And that's how we arrived at the Joker in a very naturalistic way.
Almost all characters have some kind of arc and a storyline. And then we match that with what they're wearing and why they're wearing it and when they're wearing it so that we can aid in telling that character's story. In general, you're trying to find some truth in that moment and some believability, because the best part is when the audience doesn't even notice. They just feel it. That's our goal.
Hey.
What?
I just want to take another look at you.